Since a lot of places in the world are easing the lockdown, I suppose it's a great time to have a quarantine Q&A, answering your questions, talking about how I spent the quarantine and how my adventure was, since I was literally stranded in an island that's the United Kingdom. It's been 2 months now, I think more than 2 months. And I still can't go back to my country, so yeah. So the first question is, first thing to do after quarantine is over. Oh boy. I wanna travel, I just wanna jump off the first train and go visit Edinburgh even for like a few hours. I'm just only 2.5 hours away from Edinburgh right now and I still haven't visited the city, and I need to do it before I leave. I have to, okay? I will wear my masks, I will have my gloves, I will take every protection. Actually, I don't think they will allow us to go this far, because right now Scotland is the lockdown. Scotland is taking another approach from the whole UK. And right now they took the first step at easing the lockdown, which is gatherings of people. I think no more than 8 people can go out. And you can actually go to a friend's house, and you can go as far as 5 kilometers. So I can't really go to Edinburgh because it's still kind of far, but I'm really waiting that and hoping that until the flights are open again I will be able to do that. So the next question is, what TV shows did you binge throughout the quarantine? I think most all the time I just rewatched old TV shows, so I don't have any new recommendations. I binge watched Futurama for the second time. It's an amazing TV show and I think it's a bit underrated. If you like Rick and Morty, you're gonna like Futurama because it has this kind of a weird, random sci-fi humor, so yeah. Okay, so the next question is, it's kind of irrelevant from the whole quarantine thing, but it's still a question I really, really like, and it's, what's the oldest thing you own? This is actually a really nice story. Sadly, I don't have it here with me to show it to you guys, but the oldest thing I own is a golden ring. My great-grandma, she was born at exactly 100 years before me, in 1896. And she was a tailor and a noble Turkish man commissioned her to make him this shirt of pants. I really don't know how they're called in English, so I'm just gonna pop a photo here. And she made them so good and fitting to him that he actually, apart from paying her the amount they agreed on, he took the ring off his little finger and just gave it to her. So that's the oldest thing I own. It's still, I have it in my like jewelry box back in Greece. it's really nice. It's really, really nice to have something that belonged to someone else like 100 years ago. Like, whoa. Next next question is, what movies can you quote from start to finish? I'm gonna go with Disney movie Hercules, but it's the Greek version. Συναισθηματισμοί. Έχω να νιώσω έτσι από τότε που ένα κομμάτι μου σακάει κάτι στο λαιμό μου.
Συναισθηματισμοί. Λοιπόν, έχω να πάθω τέτοιο σοκ από τότε που μια μπουκιά μου σακά στάθηκε στο λαιμό. Ε?
Next question is quarantine related again, and I got this by a lot of you guys, so I guess it's something important to everyone. I mean, it's important to me as well. And it's favorite food, snack, dish during the quarantine. Yeah, the favorite food I think I cooked most of the times is fried rice. I mostly use veggies like broccoli, mushrooms, sweet corn, peppers, and I just sprinkle the shit out of every spice I own in my drawer. But yeah, it's really healthy, it's really delicious, and only yesterday I did add some omelette because I really hate cooking eggs. I find them really disgusting, but I know that the original, the OG Chinese fried rice has omelette in it, so I decided to give it a try. Yes, it's delicious, but I nearly threw up 5 times while trying to crack the egg, so no, it's a no for me, but yeah, it's a really nice dish. Also, it's not a snack, but I drank a lot of coffee, which I don't usually drink a lot of coffee. I mostly drink it because I wanna
go to the toilet easily, yeah.
Do my scene for over there. And it doesn't help me wake up or anything. I just drink it for that reason, but I decided to stop this week, so I did not buy any new coffee, and now that it's ran out, I only have green tea. I really need the coffee. I realize how addictive caffeine is. So the next question is, what was your quarantine routine? So basically, I have a video talking about this, but since that video came out, I changed my quarantine routine a lot. If I have to put the quarantine faces with labels, I'll start with the complete panic mode. So that was in the end of March, where I was really scared and all I did was checking on the internet the news about new rules, instructions, and all the numbers of the pandemic. Then the second stage happened, which is pushing myself to be productive, in which I started painting again, I started organizing, I organized what clothes I want to keep in my capsule suitcase and what clothes I want to return to my country and keep them in my drawers forever, because if I'm to move for the next years of my life to live abroad, it's better to carry just one small luggage with only the essentials rather than all the luggages I have right now. So after that stage, I went full on to the cooking states, because I realized that trying to push myself to be creative is not actually making me create the quality of the things I want. So I just stopped doing that and started being creative and productive with other things, not just art and photography. So yeah, that was when I started cooking a lot, and baking as well, which is, it was great because I always knew that I had it in me, you know, and I never realized it till then. So yeah, after that stage, I went to the real creative stage where I uploaded my music on Bandcamp and Spotify, which was something I wanted to do since ages, I don't know, and quarantine gave me the time to actually sit down and finally upload it the right way, the way I wanted to be. So yeah, I was really glad about that. Also, I started uploading more videos on YouTube, talking to the camera and discussing all these things with you guys, since we're all in the same shoes. It was really nice actually hearing your opinions and interacting with you through my videos or my Instagram posts, and it was really, really great, since I am all alone here. I don't have my family or my friends, and you guys kept me company. I also started designing more stuff for my Etsy shop. I designed my sticker packs, and I designed way, way more stuff that I don't want to spoil right now, but I'm gonna make all of these once I return back to my country where I have all my materials. Right now, I'm in the final stage of the quarantine. I hope it's the final. It's the slump stage. All I do is always lie on my bed, chat with my friends on Discord, watch movies together, play games, nothing else. I eat and I sleep on the same bed. And I don't feel guilty because I already did so many stuff through this time. I reflected so much and it helped me realize what I want to do and where I want to go once I have the chance to actually reach out to the world and the people, because right now we gotta stay safe. Enough, I rambled a lot with this. So let's go to the next one. Your future plans and how is the situation in Scotland? How are people doing and such? So, as I said before, the situation in Scotland right now is kind of better because they just started lifting the lockdown, although we need to just check every 3 weeks how the numbers are going, and if they spike again, I guess they're gonna lock everyone in their houses again and maybe it's gonna be stricter. But for now, it's being really great. Back in Greece, they lifted the lockdown completely and people are out on the streets, out on the beaches, and I'm glad that that's happening, but I'm also scared. I don't want a second wave of the pandemic to happen, so yeah. So yeah, my future plans are, right now I'm just trying to plan for the near future and not that ahead of time. So right now I just want to return to my country and spend my summer there focusing on my etchy shop, my photography, my music, create more, share it with you guys and the world, because this is what I want to do, hopefully, somewhere in the future. I'm still looking for graphic designing universities, somewhere in Canada maybe, but that's completely vague and theoretical. I don't know how things are gonna go. But yeah, that's my future plans for the near future. And I'm just gonna answer one last question, because I don't want this video to be like 2 hours long. How can you be so productive and artistic? What inspires you to create all these beautiful things? First of all, thank you very much. Well, I don't have any secrets, honestly. The things that inspire me vary from time to time. Right now, I'm really inspired by the whole cottagecore aesthetic, and I believe that's because I'm living in Scotland. And I get this Scottish countryside kind of vibe, and so I'm inspired to create similar stuff. I really get inspired from Pinterest. I have a lot of mood boards with all the different things I like. Other than that, I get really inspired by classical music and classical paintings. I don't know what it is with all these old stuff, but I don't relate with most of the pop culture stuff, and this sounds,
oh, look at me, I'm so quirky, but
really, I don't know, there's something with classical artists and classical composers that, I don't know, it gets me really, really inspired. When I listen to a classical piece, I just wanna create a short movie, take photos, write poems. I really don't know, it's really great, and I can't wait to go back to Greece, because I have my route where I just listen to music, walk by the beach, and then go sit on a bench under the shadows, because that the time that I usually go is in early afternoon and it's really sunny, and I read a book or write poetry, and it's really nice because some people or some random people come to me, sit next to me and start talking to me about poetry and philosophy and things like that, and it's really nice. I kind of miss this, to be honest, so I really can't wait to return. And now I feel nostalgic. As much as I want to go back and spend my summer in Greece relaxing and forgetting all this nightmare that happened with the pandemic, I really want to be able to return in Scotland in the future, to stay for a little longer and do what I wasn't able to do now. But yeah, this quarantine was really, really beneficial, although it gave me a lot of anxiety and calories. Anyway, enough with the rambling. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you do, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!